Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. I'm trying out my new invention today, the Qbot 9001. I'm using machine learning technology to generate incredible, thought-provoking questions to answer. So, let's test it out now.
Yeah, prepare to be amazed.
Let's see what we have here. Why can't people just drink a jar of their own spit to stay hydrated? Well, clearly I have some bugs to work out with this Qbot, but this is a science channel, so I'm still gonna answer it. Your body is constantly producing saliva, every single day, even when you're asleep. On a daily basis, that means you're swallowing roughly 1 to 2 liters of spit, and up to 99% of that is water. So if you wanted to, for some reason, to gather a jar of your spit, or dare I say, the spit of another to stay hydrated, would that work? Well, first off, don't do that. Second, let's consider this logically. Each day, the human body loses 2 to 3 liters of water from breathing, sweating, and going to the bathroom. If this vital fluid is not consistently replenished, then dehydration sets in. One of the earliest signs is thirst, and that's probably going to make your mouth and tongue feel like the desert. So wait, where did all that saliva go that you were planning on drinking? Well, the simple fact is when your body is losing water, there just isn't enough fluid left over to produce normal amounts of spit. When your body's fluid level drops, it's actually activating your fight or flight response, and this sends a signal to your salivary glands to conserve their usual watery output. If you want to properly quench your thirst, what you really need is a source of H2O outside your body. So what if you prepared for future dehydration by storing up vast reserves of spit? Again, don't do this, it won't work, but there's a good reason for that. You see, hydration isn't just about fluid levels. It's also about what's contained in those fluids. Even though saliva is made mostly of water, it also contains electrolytes, mucus, enzymes, bacteria, and bicarbonate. This makes saliva much more concentrated than just plain old water, and your body can tell the difference. The water you actually drink will enter your stomach and then the bloodstream. From here, it's the job of your kidneys to filter through the contents and maintain a nice balance of water and solutes in the body. At first, after drinking water, the concentration of solutes in your circulatory system are diluted. And to balance this out, excess water will move into your cells and organs, hydrating them via the system of osmosis. The problem is, because the kidneys are so good at their job, the fluid that is lost from your body, like saliva, has about the same concentration of solutes as the rest of your body. This means that if you drink your own spit, the body isn't gaining any extra electrolytes or water, and so this just isn't going to inspire any water movement or hydration. But all of that's assuming you're drinking the right saliva. When you get dehydrated, your saliva becomes less watery and more mucousy, and if this thick liquid is concentrated enough when you drink it later on, it could actually draw fluid away from your vital organs instead of to them, dehydrating your cells and making you thirstier. No matter which way you bottle it, don't bottle it, Triangle Bob, saliva just isn't going to hydrate you. But that's not exactly a bad thing. If spit was made solely from water, humans would choke more often on food. Bacteria would flourish in your mouth. Your teeth would be at risk of decay. And you might even lose a sense of taste. Saliva is great for many reasons, but just make sure to keep it in your mouth for the maximum benefits. So why don't you give me some great questions down below so that I can feed it to Qbot 9001, and maybe it'll learn what a great question is. If you thought this spit video was interesting, you should probably check out the one we did on the tiny creatures living in your water. These and other disease-causing microbes are called pathogens. If we come into contact with them and they enter our bodies, they can cause an infection. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.